first choice of bit, if I have a new horse on the yard, a young horse, I don't know it at all, would be the KK Ultra. As we can see from the KK Ultra, it's a double jointed bit. It has a lozenge in the middle. If I hold the KK Ultra up, we can see the lozenge is angled. And this is angled for a very important reason. If I lay the bit on my hand, this is the, imagine the bit in the horse's mouth, it has no contact, loose reins. If I take up a contact, then we can see that the bit's actually rotated in the horse's mouth by 45 degrees. So the lozenge in the middle of the KK Ultra has been rotated by 45 degrees to accommodate that. This is the Duo, it's a plastic mouthpiece, and if we look at it, there's two sides of it. There's a straight side at the top and the side that's angled up. I would generally bit it with the angled up bit next to the tongue. This gives the tongue more room, takes the pressure off the tongue. These are very good starting bits and excellent bits used in young and very sensitive horses. My next choice would be the Dynamic. It's based on the same principle as the KK Ultra. It has the rotated lozenge in the centre of the bit. If I hold the KK Ultra up next to the Dynamic, we can see the Dynamic has curved arms to the bit. What the curved arms create is more contact through the whole of the horse's mouth. It's still dressage legal, it's still a very nice, kind bit. It's got a slightly louder voice than the KK Ultra. We'll talk now about the difference between a loose ring and an egg butt. If I take a loose ring bit, the bit is shaking. There's a lot of movement in the mouthpiece. If I take an egg butt and shake the egg butt, not a lot happens. As a very simple rule of thumb, if you have a horse that mouths the bit too much, plays with the bit too much, put an egg butt in them, they can't move it around in their mouth as much. If you have a horse that's too still in the mouth, you want them to mouth a bit more, and loose ring's the way forward. Another way to create more salivation in the horse is to use the KKWH Ultra. We're looking at the little disc in the middle of the bit, the middle of the lozenge, that the horse can play with. Like, it stimulates the tongue and stimulates the horse to salivate. It's very important the horse does salivate. The salivation process encourages the horse to relax. And we want the horse to have a relaxed jaw that creates submission. So this is a great benefit of the WH Ultra in creating that. It can also help hold the horse's attention. A recent development from Sprenger is the Novo Contact. It's quite a different, unique shape. It's an oval concept to the bit. What this has resulted in, that we haven't got the bulkiness where the bit would actually sit in the corners of the horse's mouth, but the unique oval shape of the bit has increased the surface area contact with the tongue. This unique shape and design of the Novo Contact has resulted in a bit that the horses have accepted very well. They're very good for horses that are very light mouthed and sensitive, and have been very well received by them. They come in two types. We can have a single jointed Novo Contact and a double jointed Novo Contact. The unique design of the single jointed Novo Contact has resulted in there being no nutcracker effect on this single jointed bit. All the bits I've talked about so far are BD, dressage and FEI legal. We're all very safe to compete in them. They're all very kind and mild bits. For me, jumping bits fall into three categories. I'll quickly talk through each different type of jumping bit. Within those different ranges, there's many options, many variations. There would need a much more in-depth conversation. Helens are very good for horses that have a high head carriage. The curb action of the bit helps them round and lower onto the contact in a very submissive way. Here we have a Cheltenham running gag. This would have the opposite effect of a Pelham. These are very good for horses that would carry their heads too low and that you wanted to lift their heads and raise them up a little bit higher. The running action of the gag, as you pull the rein, physically lifts the bit in the horse's mouth. This is a universal gag. It can come in many different forms. It's an extremely versatile bit, as there's many options, different options where we can attach the reins. We can have roundings, we can have two reins, we can have a rein on the snaffle ring, a rein on the bottom ring. We also can have the option of having a back strap that gives some pressure to the back of the jaw. They can be very useful with horses that can sit out against the contact. A great way for you to experience and understand how the bit lies and feels and affects the horse in the mouth is if you take a single jointed bit, which will have a normal nutcracker effect. This is what we're trying to avoid with the Sprenger bits. You lay it on your arm and have a pull down on your arm, and you can feel the pressure that this part of the bit applies to your arm. You take, this is a Sprenger cake out, a double jointed bit. The design and the philosophy behind this bit is to take away any nutcracker effect. Exactly the same, you fold it around your arm and pull down, you'll be able to feel there's much less pressure on these points on your arm.